All right, we're finally at the last episode. We have learned vocabulary and concepts. We learned how to set up our very first hot wallet and some protocols, procedures, and tips to keep in mind just to stay safe when using the hot wallet. And now finally, we are going to be taking that hot wallet. We are going to be adding the Polygon network to it. We are going to be bridging our ETH from the Ethereum network to the Polygon network. And then finally, we are going to be swapping our Polygon ETH to Polygon mana. And bada bing, bada boom, what did I tell you? We will be done. We will have our mana. We will be ready to jump into Decentraland, play some of the risk-to-earn games brought to you by the Holy Ones, the sponsor of this episode, and enjoy all the other pleasures of Decentraland and their secondary market, outfit our avatars with some sweet drip, as the kids would say. I don't know. I don't speak TikTok fluently. In any case, let's dive right into it. This episode is brought to you by TheHolyOnes.io, a refreshingly unique NFT project that is actually delivering on its roadmap, unlike 99% of the pipe dream projects that are out there. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever wanted to own your own casino? Well, owning one of the NFTs from TheHolyOnes is actually going to give you a share in their metaverse casino games. Less than 3 months since their mint open, they've already produced three risk-to-earn games that lets metaverse players risk real cryptocurrency to win real cryptocurrency. 20% of the proceeds actually gets distributed back to the DAO. That means as a holder of the NFT, you're partaking in those profits. You guys know I've been buying their NFTs and talking about the Holy Ones for months, so this is not just a flavor of the week NFT shilling. I loved this project months ago, I love it even more today, and I'm going to continue to buy and hold these NFTs. Obviously, this isn't financial advice and you should do your own research, but you're gonna find awesome utility, proven and doxed team, amazing community, and hilariously unique branding that helped this project stand out above all of the noise of all the derivative projects and overhyped, under-delivered roadmaps that are just ubiquitous throughout the NFT space. Nothing we say is ever financial advice, but we do advise that you do your own research, go to TheHolyOnes.io, join the Discord, ask some questions, engage with the community, and see if you become a believer. So here are the instructions. This is something really easy. I'm going to put the link below, but I would only follow the instructions whenever you're adding a network or really doing anything. Don't rely on GitHub or Reddit. Someone might be making mistakes or they might be doing something more nefarious. If you're going to be doing anything serious with cryptocurrency, moving it around, giving access or setting up networks, any of that jazz, make sure you're getting it from a reputable source. So this is actually from Polygon's website. It's legit stuff. There's two ways to do this. We can use the Polygon scan or we can do it manually. I want to show you guys the manual way. The automatic way using Polygon scan doesn't always work. The manual way is tried and true. It seems a little confusing, but once you do it, you're gonna be like, wow, that's it. That was that simple. So again, this link will be in the show notes, but you could also Google how to add Polygon network to fill in the blank, whatever your hot wallet is. In this case, we're using MetaMask. So basically what we're gonna be doing is using these instructions here, we're going to be putting these things in the appropriate fields, and I'll walk you through all of that. We're going to be going up to our MetaMask extension. I'm going to click on that bad boy. And in the last video, I showed you that we can add additional networks, and that's exactly what we're going to be doing. So as you can see right now, we've only got one network option. Makes it easy to keep track of what network we're on. Doesn't get confusing. But as we start adding networks, it's going to get confusing. So as I mentioned in the last video, before you flip out and you think your stuff is missing because you can't see it or can't find it, check that you're in the right account on the right network. So adding a network, and see these fields, they correspond to the information that we just saw in the last one. And we just follow this right along. So as you can see, network name, Polygon mainnet. Next thing I need is the new RPC URL. Just going to copy and paste it. Chain ID, 137, 137, currency symbol. I already know it's going to be Matic. As I mentioned before, Matic is the token for Polygon. Then block explorer URL. We just copy and paste Polyscan in there. Now we're going to save. And boom, where'd that ETH go? It's all gone. What happened to ETH? Well, as I mentioned, right now you'd be flipping out because you're looking at your assets and you're like, I don't have any ETH. I know I had three ETH in here. What happened? Go up here to your network, drop down. Now we're on the Ethereum network. Now we can see your ETH. Now we're going to want to import tokens. Before we do that, we're going to want to make sure that we have a place for those tokens to reside and show up. Now the good news is, being that it's blockchain, you can actually do this after you've sent the tokens to the wallet, but it's always better, in my opinion, to have this done beforehand. So you know you've got a mitt to catch the ball, so to speak. So what we're going to do is we're going to go down to import tokens, and we want mana, correct? So what we're going to do is we're going to look up mana on the Polygon network. We're going to go to polygonscan.com, and that's Polygon scan with an N, not scam. That would be a red flag. As you can see, we can look it up by its address, transaction hash, block, or token. And we're going to be looking up the token mana, M-A-N-A. Here it is right here, top of the list. Now, you do want to make sure you enter in any information correctly here, because there are some pretty clever scammers out there who will put in very similar addresses or names, and they don't get picked up right away by Polygon. And if you accidentally put this information, the wrong information, into your wallet, could be bad news bears for you. So we want to double check. This is the token for Decentraland. It's mana. It's all spelled correctly. It looks like it's got the right volume, the right price. I'm extremely confident that this is mana. This is what I'm looking for. So now all I want to do is copy this contract address, and I can click this little copy address icon right here that shows up when my mouse hovers over it. Copied, go over here and paste the token address. Now the symbol is mana and the decimal points are 18. Now, where I got that was right here, decimal 18. Going back to MetaMask, add custom token, and we've got a place for mana to reside. Now, when we go back to the main screen, we see that where I once just had Matic, I now have mana as well. Now, we still have to add ETH, and that's actually just as simple. It's a little bit more confusing. So again, we're going to go to import tokens, and this is where we're going to be putting in the same information. Again, we're doing this on Polygon. So where are we going to go? Polygonscan.com. Here we are at polygonscan.com. We're going to be looking up for wrapped Ether. So it's actually W-E-T-H. And there are a couple of different options, and this is where it gets confusing. In this instance, we actually want this one right here that just says wrapped Ether, W-E-T-H. You can see that the price is similar to what, or it is the same as what the market price is right now. We've got a similar price right here, which is a little confusing. But as you can see, what's in parentheses is W-E-T-H, and that means wrapped Ether. And wrapped is just a term that's used where you're using Ether, but you're using it either on a different network or it has some other abilities. For instance, on OpenSea, when you do bidding, you're actually using wrapped Ether, and you have to convert your ETH to wrapped ETH in order to basically put a bid out. And what that allows you to do, just getting a little bit off topic, is I could actually, let's say I only have one ETH in my wallet, I can actually bid out one ETH on multiple different NFTs on OpenSea, even though I only have one ETH to bid. But until those bids are accepted or the time runs out, I haven't actually spent any of that ETH. Another thing that I kind of alluded to is I can make it so that bid is only good for a certain amount of days. Maybe I have some other intentions on spending that ETH. And if this person doesn't take this bid within the next 2 days, on day three, I already know I want to spend it somewhere else when there's another opportunity coming up. So I don't want to have that bid lingering or committed out there. I want to withdraw it, or I want it automatically withdrawn if someone else accepts a bid that would eat up that amount. That way I'm not stuck bidding on all of these different projects or just bidding on one project because I can't bid on multiple. And if this guy doesn't accept my bid and that guy would have, I missed out because I was only bidding with Ether. When you have the wrapped ETH, it allows you to have a little bit more intelligence in a situation like that and some others. But getting back to it, what we want is the WETH. That's what we've got right here. And again, just like before, we're going to copy this bad boy. Come on over, paste it there. Got 18 decimals just like before. Oh, look, it automatically recognized it. And we're going to add that. So now we go and go back to our account. And now we've got wrapped ETH, mana, and Matic on our Polygon network. And again, if we switch over to our regular Ethereum network, the only tokens that we have there are ETH. And this is regular old ETH. All right, so now we've got the Polygon network added to our MetaMask. We've got a place for our mana and our ETH to reside in our MetaMask on the Polygon network. The next step is going to be bridging that ETH to Polygon. So we have that wrapped ETH we've been talking about. And we're going to be doing that on OpenSea. So we're going to head on over to OpenSea.io. If you're not familiar with it, OpenSea.io is like the biggest NFT trading marketplace. You can buy and sell and even do mints right here on OpenSea. You got two icons up here. One is going to be your wallet. And this other one that looks like a little person, that's your profile. So you've got your profile, you got your watch list, any projects you want to keep an eye on, and you just want to have a quick list. Now, this isn't my normal account. This is the account that we just set up. So I don't have really anything to show you as far as what my collections are, my watch list, my favorites, or the NFTs that I'm holding in my profile. But that's where you would see all of this stuff. Now, again, as I mentioned in the previous video, With Web3, you don't have an account on this website. Your MetaMask is your account. So as long as you're logged into your hot wallet, I should say, in this case, it is MetaMask. But as long as you're logged into your hot wallet and that hot wallet has a network that is compatible with that given marketplace, you don't have an account there. You just show up. It recognizes that you're logged in and it can automatically see which NFTs or cryptocurrencies you have. And now when I go over to wallet, since this is the first time I've gone to OpenSea with this wallet, it is going to ask my permission to sync the two. As you can see, there's several different wallets that you can use. MetaMask at the top happens to be the most popular, as they show there. And I have to actually sign and give permission for OpenSea to access my MetaMask account. I'm going to click next, saying, yes, it is account one that I want to give you access to. It's going to ask again if I give it permission to see the address, the account balance, activity, and suggest transactions to approve. It doesn't give it the ability to approve transactions, and that's something that's very important. It basically says, hey, can we see into your wallet to see how much Ether you have, how much cryptocurrency you have, I should say, what NFTs you have, so we can list all of those and allow you to do transactions to either buy or list the assets that you wish. So I'm going to hit connect and it's connecting. All right. So I realized that I couldn't use that empty account to show you what I wanted to show you. So I've switched over to one of my backup accounts. And as you can see, the screen is on night mode because that's how I like to roll. I suggest it for yourself as well. Give those eyes a break. But we're going to go to wallet. And now, even though I only have 48 cents of ETH in my wallet, I can show you what I want to show you, which is the next step. Hypothetically, at this point, we've got your hot wallet. It's now been connected and synced with OpenSea. So as you can see, OpenSea is able to see the NFTs that are in my wallet, as well as any cryptocurrency that is in my wallet. And it sees that I have Ethereum. Now, if I click on that wallet, I see my balances. And let's say you've got that Ethereum that you're looking to convert into mana on Polygon. Again, this is ETH on Ethereum, as you can see right there, ETH over Ethereum. What I can do is click on more, and I can bridge to Polygon right here. Now, not only is this super easy and simple, as most people who are in this space are familiar with OpenSea and they're buying and selling and trading NFTs, but what else is nice is OpenSea has made this more affordable. They've made this much cheaper. Why? Well, because this isn't their primary business. They're not trying to profit off of bridging fees. They're trying to make it as easy as possible to convert to whatever cryptocurrency you want on whatever network you want in order to purchase NFTs. So they've made this feature available with probably assumption on their end, assuming that they are going to be allowing you to make that transaction, and that's where they're going to be making their money. So you would just bridge this ETH from ETH on Ethereum to ETH on Polygon, and that will create that wrapped ETH that I mentioned before. Again, I click on that. It's going to ask for how much I want to convert. It's going to now show up with this purple diamond. As you notice right here, ETH over Polygon versus ETH over Ethereum. We've got the white grayish diamond versus the purple diamond. Purple is the Polygon color. So I put in how much I want to convert. In this case, I'm not going to do anything because I don't even have enough to pay the gas fees, but it would then convert it to Polygon. And then in your MetaMask account, you will now have ETH on Polygon. And I'll switch back over to the other account to show you where that's going to show up. All right, here we are back at the MetaMask account that we just set up for this tutorial. As you can see, all the balances are zero. But if I go to the Polygon mainnet and I check right here, this is where that wrapped ETH would be showing up. I would now have a balance there, and that would be deducted from whatever balance I had over here with the ETH. So we'd see this go down and we would see this wrapped ETH increase. You can also, this is the website view of it, but you could also see all of this stuff. If you click on the extension, you'll see the dropdown. It's very similar, just more compact. So again, we want to look for the network dropdown, make sure we're on the right network that we want to be on. We've got the tokens down here. And again, if I went through and did this for real, we would have the wrapped ETH right here. And again, just to reiterate, avoid that confusion. If you have multiple accounts set up, before you get used to this, it might be a little stressful to log into the wrong account on the wrong network and see some zeros where you don't expect them to be. Make sure you're on the right account. This makes it easy. I only have one account in this dummy account. Then we want to make sure we're on the right network. We only have two, but even that can get confusing. And we would see that wrapped ETH right here. Then what we would do is we would select this wrapped ETH. Again, this is the ETH that is now on Polygon. And we do a swap. Click on the swap, and it allows us to select which currency, which token we want to swap to. So now again, this is all being done on the Polygon network. So when I ask it to swap to mana, it is swapping to mana on Polygon. And again, there are third-party sites that will do this for you, but it is cheaper and easier to do it the way that I've shown you. What's nice about this is it's a more common pair. There are some more rare, not as ubiquitous or not as heavily supported tokens that are out there, and that will require you to go to one of those third-party swapping sites. But in this instance, we're just trying to take ETH on Ethereum to Mana on Polygon, and that's something that we can easily do between OpenSea and our hot wallet. And from here, we log on to Decentraland, we track down one of the games that the Holy Ones are offering, put down some mana, maybe we'll buy some tickets to Mana Mania and enter the raffle. Maybe we'll play the devil in a game of war, or we'll play some old school rock, paper, scissor. See who's got the quickest hands and the best luck. And that's just the games that they've got right now. Who knows what games they're going to have live by the time you're watching this video. A lot of exciting things coming down the pipeline. I know as a member, I insist that you do some research. Check out theholyones.io. Check out the Discord, join, ask questions, get familiar with the people in the community, the team, and the concept and what we've got coming down the pipeline. Some stuff I'm really, really excited about. Lots of cool, unique, and creative games coming down the pipeline. So you're definitely going to want to be in tune and stay abreast to all of that. Links are going to be in the show notes. If you have any questions that I didn't cover or something I didn't go into enough detail in, or if maybe down the road there becomes some easier way to do this swap, I know the Holy Ones are going to be working on a much more streamlined process, which I'm excited to share with you guys when it's available. Let me know if you know a better way to do it, but this is the easiest and the cheapest way that I've been able to find. And like I said, it makes it really easy when you're just using your own hot wallet and OpenSea. A lot of the other tutorials that have you using these different third-party sites, I don't know if they're getting kickbacks or what, but it seems complicated, seems like a headache, not sure which order to do it in. This is it. ETH on Ethereum to Mana on Polygon. Bada bing, bada boom, you're done. Adios.